Everybody, thank you, thank you, thank you so much. I appreciate it.
Wonderful.
Wonderful, wonderful.
And how are you?
I am well. I'm just enjoying how the response of this book is going on, and it was a project in the making for a long time. I just kind of put it to the back burner till, you know, the universe was like, no, now's the time, you need to do it now, and it's all I could think about. So I said, you know what, let me write it, and I wrote it so quickly that, you know, my closest colleagues and friends and one of my accountability partners was like, you must have had that on your mind for a while because you wrote it so quick. And I was like, yeah, I did. Let's do it again. Let's do another one. But I'm just enjoying it. And, you know, my author name is Malia. My real name is Malia Hoston, but I go by Malia V. The V is for victory. And I wrote this book just to break down the steps. You know, I'm a natural since 1998. You know, I've had 5 big chops during the course of, you know, the transition and being natural. Did everything from the curls to the dreads to twist to afro, just like the lady that you brought on previously, that's doing the natural hair parade. Oh, it was so awesome. I wish I could be in Dallas right now. But yes, the stories is just similar. You see, you're just hearing similar stories. And if that sister is still listening, if you come to Atlanta, you stay at my house anytime, no problem.
And that was going to be my next question, that as to where you are. So you are in Atlanta, and I haven't read the book, but I had a question for you just from what you just said. Now, whose transition are we reading? Because, you know, everyone transitions different. They experience different things. Of course, it's similar. Is it a 1-2 step, or are we reading your experience?
It's both. You're reading my collection of experience and tips. However, it's a daily step program geared toward you, to focus on you, to get you where you need to be. So it's more not necessarily like a book that you keep reading. It's more like an interactive book, kind of like a workbook, you know. The step one, okay, well, get the closet together. Step two, okay, get the mind together, because if the mind and the heart is together, then, you know, everything else will come into place. You know, how do you prepare for this? How do you prepare for the naysayers? How do you prepare? How do you know what hair type you have? How do you know if your hair is dry or moisturized or 3A or 4C? It goes through all of those steps before you get to that point where you're like, oh my goodness, what am I? You know, it prepares you, it organizes you. So before that situation arises, you're already prepared. That way you can go, oh, I know this. I already did the research and work for this. So I can just step over this and keep going to the next thing I have to master with this transition into natural hair.
That's very intriguing, because it sounds like you're causing everyone to be conscious of the spiritual journey that you go on when you reclaim yourself, that most people are not aware of, because most people, like we've said many times here at Love and After Me, that the starting place for a lot of people is hair. And then from hair, people venture out into the different aspects and in the different, you know, rooms, sort of say, of this mansion. However, it sounds like you're putting it in perspective for everybody to say, okay, it's wonderful that you are at this point, and you reach this point of reclaiming yourself and embracing your natural you. However, it's more than that. And for you to be successful, these are some things for you to be aware of. And then you also aid people on the physical level in terms of hair types and different routines and regimens that can be successful across the board. Am I understanding that right?
Yes, you are right on point. And, you know, it also helps with the mental, because you have, you know, your affirmations. You celebrate your successes. Don't worry about the naysayers. That book will prepare you for the naysayers. You know, it'll give you past the point where, you know, this is in volume two, but it'll the point where it's too short to be long, but too long to be short. You know, it's not long enough to go in a ponytail, but
yeah,
it's not short enough to still have two. It covers all of that, because, you know, again, I've done it five times, so I had to get reminded, oh, yeah, this phase is coming up, and that phase is coming up. So what I'm doing is I'm helping you help you.
Okay.
So in essence, you know, and then with that, you know, you can always help someone else because you'll know what point you're at next and what to expect. And just, you know, to piggyback on what the sister said earlier, about, you know, women empowerment and how that, you know, festival is going to be on women empowerment. You know, we know, and at least this is my opinion, black women have set the standards for the Western woman with fashion, with hair, with beauty, the lips, the hips, the clothes. All of that is by what we have established. The hip-hop generation, music, you know, TVs and cars now, we're just inventors by nature. So when I hear the Dalai Lama say the world will be saved by the Western woman, I will say, you know, that's true. But I'm going to take it a step further and say the world is going to be saved not only by the Western woman, but by the melanated woman as she prepares to get herself together to like herself and radiate that out to everyone else, and everyone else follows suit. So this right here is a journey just to express that. And, you know, the natural hair, you know, when I became natural, it wasn't a statement. It wasn't a black power statement or here I am or look at me. It was just, you know, I was ready to be free out the box. I was ready to be liberated. What's wrong with wanting to be me, right?
Mm-hmm.
What's
yeah.
wrong with wanting to be who I am and what is naturally growing out my hair and have that be okay? What's wrong with that? So, you know, as this is growing, that same question is being asked. It's not the same 60s movement. It's just wanting to be you and be okay with that and be beautiful and feel liberated. That is the foundation of this book.
Mm-hmm.
That's the foundation.
Now, I want you to remind everyone what it is that you're offering, like what day are we on, how much time do they have to still get it free on Amazon?
Mm-hmm. The Kindle ebook is free until Saturday.
Okay.
And you can go to www.curlycrown.com and, you know, subscribe, and then the autoresponder will send you a link, or you can go directly on Amazon. And it's the author's name is Melia V. That's M-E-L-I-A, and then V, just the letter V.
Okay. And I know you mentioned earlier, you said the response, you know, you love the response that you're getting back from the book. Now, we know, we're hearing from Robin, or we know Robin is, you know, getting into it. And I would like to know, I mean, what responses are you actually getting?
Okay, sure. Well, just today I got a response from a lady who was, she had lupus. And so she had lupus on her scalp, and she had to cut her hair off. So she is now, you know, unfortunately, she's in a position where she's forcing people, where she's forced to kind of take the natural route in order to get better, as opposed to somebody who just does it naturally. And so when I recommended my book to her, you know, she was like, you know, she really didn't know what to do. I mean, she had so many other things going on. So with this, it was like, okay, well, do this. Okay, cool. We'll do this. Okay, cool. It made it so much simpler because it was an organized type format. So in that to me is my inspirational story of the response that I'm getting.
Okay. And what else do you have in store? I mean, if you can say, what's up your sleeve?
Sure. Well, the book is a two-volume book, which the volume one is out, and it covers the first 45 days, and then the next volume will be out. It also comes with, which I'm going to have a special with later, but an ETF CD. And the ETF, well, I'm not going to, we'll just have to come back on a later show to show that special, but it will be a special coming out when the ETF CD comes out to go along with the book. And then I just have a slew of ideas on all the different subjects I want to attack and get interest and introspective on. Just this, the natural hair and the mentality of the natural hair and being empowered and feeling good and embracing, you know, what naturally grows out of your hair. I hope that answers your question.
Yes, it does. Okay. You actually reminded me. Go ahead, Robin.
Robin's having a slow moment. I'm sorry. Can you say what ETF stands for?
I'm sorry. Did I say ETF? I'm sorry. Emotionally. It is. I'm having a brain fart here. It is emotionally transferred energy. So what you do is, it's kind of like a type of meditation where you tap certain meridians on your body to help you relax immediately. So Deepak Chopra recommends one of this technique in order to help, you know, calm your nerves and release stress. So I said, you know, hey, why not give them everything that they can use, all of the tools that they can use to help with this process.
Okay. You're speaking of EFT.
Aspect.
Are you speaking of EFT? Emotional
yes.
freedom technique? Okay. Yeah.
Yes. Yes.
Okay.
Yes. There it goes. There it came out. Yeah. I had a brain fart right there.
Yes. Oh, and that definitely works. I mean, I have. There's a video with audio and visual that I play at times, and it's
mm-hmm.
tapping to hope, no, and
mm-hmm.
it definitely does work. So
it does work.
You reminded me of something, and I don't know if you've already thought about this. There is, with what it is that I do, and I mentioned this, I think, a couple of weeks ago, I love what I do from home because I get to assist quite a few different people. I mean, all these different people with different ideas that they want to accomplish and what they want to do. I just need to put it together for the internet world, you know, make it make sense in that sense. So one
mm-hmm.
of my clients has a book that describes or talks about a certain type of hair cutting technique. And,
mm-hmm.
you know, in me doing a website and things of that nature, I also see the comments or the mail that comes through it. So a lot of the mail responses are like, yes, this is a great idea. I can understand it. I can really see how it works, but when I get the book, you know, this person is like overseas. When I get the book, I come to find that it doesn't serve me. I can't really do anything with it. I'm just reading it and seeing pictures.
Uh-huh.
So
uh-huh.
I had when I saw that, I was like, man, you know, I can understand that. That's like you finding out about a technique that will really work for your hair, and you have been wanting help with your hair for so long. You finally hear somebody talking about something that makes sense, but now you don't know how to do it because there's nothing to see and no one to talk to about it. So I was thinking
right.
That there should be, or someone should come out with a book that has a video with it that
uh-huh.
actually shows, it like has tutorials and techniques and things
mm-hmm.
of that nature. I don't know if you thought about this, but I mean it's
yeah,
only so much
you
can learn from just the pictures, you know.
Right. I think you ruined her surprise event.
Yeah, you did. You let a lot of cats out the bag.
Well, you know what? It's still, you know, that's just me saying. It's still, you know, it's going to be different.
Yeah,
what, you know, I'm sure what you're going to do.
Yeah, it's good.
But I felt compelled to say that because I can really, I can hear in reading the person's words, I can hear their frustration with wanting to go to the next level, but not knowing where in the world to start. Because they can't, they can't see the words. They can't just see words and know how to do it. So, anyway, okay, excuse me.
Yes.
So.
That's another show. That's another show.
Do you do any consultations?
Right now, no. This is all new. So I'm sure as time progresses, that will be on the agenda. But right now, it's just, you know, trying to get the base down, trying to get the foundation.
Okay,
if
well,
I
let everyone
ask,
know. Yes, go ahead.
You mentioned earlier, a couple times actually, about five times, big chops, five times transitioning. I'm not sure if you speak about that in the book, however. Will you speak to us about whether that was spiritual or physical, or was it trial and error, or what was it that produced it to take place five times?
It was
all of that. I'll tell you about the first two times. The first two times were pretty much back to back.
Okay, so I got the inclination to do this, you know, and it helps to have support. It always helps to have support. And my friend, she's like, yeah, you should do it, and I'll help you out, do your comb twist or whatever. And I was like, I don't know. So I finally did it, right? So I grew some new growth out. I grew it to about 2 inches, and then I went and got it cut. Well, halfway through, I started getting kind of cold feet. So I'm sorry, that's my son in the background. Kind of distract him, but so I got a cut, and I started getting cold feet, and I was like, well, you know, maybe if I just get a texturizer, that helps, you know, just so I can ease over into it, you know, just put one foot in the water, because the water is cold, just ease into it. Well, the person who did my texturizer, they just totally did it wrong. I mean, some parts were curly, some parts were straight. Some parts were, you know, halfway texturized, some parts were not. And it was like, oh, wow, I got to start all over. So I braided my hair and put it in crochet braids, because that's when crochet braids were out, you know. And I said, okay, I'll let it grow two more months and then start over. So when I let it grow 2 more months, and it was like, okay, I gotta chop it off again, because, you know, the half texturized part is not going to work because it looks crazy with the new growth. So I got it cut properly at a barbershop at the time, and just let my friend, you know, the single comb twists that were out at the time. You pick a little comb and you twist it around, and that's how I started, and I grew my locks from then.
So would you say that when you got that trim, that cut, to repair the texturizer, that was your second?
That was my second time.
Okay. Now, did you experience? Now, I remember those. I'm gonna backtrack a little bit. I remember those little spiral twists because I transitioned in '98 and I grew it out all the way into. I did a big chop in '98, cut it all the way off, really, really low, and then got it colored. I got it colored and I grew it out. And I transitioned. To the fro. I had the fro for a while, and then I did those twists, and I locked up. I definitely remember those the maintenance of those little spiral twists. Now, my question is, during this time, the first chop, the second chop, and any transition time after that, did you or were you aware of any mental and spiritual transitions you were experiencing during that time?
Yes, because the reason why I did it is just like, I don't know, I guess I was following my inner gut, and it's just like, you know, let's do this. The time is right to do this. Now, the mental, because there's the spiritual one, and then there's the subconscious, the mental, right? I speak about this in my book. I said, it's like driving a car. At first, you're nervous. You know, you really don't do too much, and then till you get the hang of it, you can pretty much, you know, talk on the phone, put on your makeup, whatever. Driving a car is second nature.
Yeah.
Getting to the point where I loved my hair, where it became second nature, really didn't occur to me until many years later, because it wasn't cool then. So, you know, you basically are fighting against forces that don't like your hair, don't like the way it looks. Why are you doing it like this? Oh, you're a pretty girl. Why are you wearing your hair like this? And the locks aren't pretty. And, oh, this fro, where is this fro coming from? Oh, gosh, your hair is high. Is your hair real? Is that your hair? Can I touch it? And it's just all this non-supportive attention. And it wasn't until years later, like how you said, that where it became the unconscious competence. The driving, being able to drive the car naturally, where it's like, you know what, I love my hair. You know, when I go out and walk out and the breeze hits it and that curl sweeps upon my face, it's like the best thing ever since sliced bread. To get to that level, you know, that's where my book series and what, you know, Malia B presents Curly Crown is really focusing on. Targeting it, whether it be hairstyles that do it or transition that does it, that's the underlying message to get to that simple driving the car where it's second nature.
And you know, that's beautiful because I agree. I think that for most women, I don't even think it's partial to curl pattern type, that we all, it takes us a moment. And I want to say, because it is a spiritual and a mental journey, to arrive at the definition of I love myself, my complete self, my total self, from crown to soul, because we had to go through an adjustment while everybody else around us had everything that they had to say about our transition and our change and how they viewed it in our own selves. When we were looking at the mirror, we had our own thoughts and concerns about what we were looking at. And even the daily maintenance of it, I can remember the type of styles that are presented today and the different variations, it wasn't widely known back then. Like, in 98, nobody knew to get on YouTube and watch, you know, different nationalistas style their hair. Like, who was talking about that? Like, nobody knew that.
Right.
And if you knew another natural person, like, there was such a difference in the texture that you all couldn't share hair tips, you know what I mean? And your hair could have been a short length, and her hair was a long length, and, you know, she could have started with long hair. Like, so it wasn't a community like it is now, so we were dealing with that much more on our plate back then than now. So I totally agree that it is a gradual process, and it's almost like raising a child and instilling in the child certain positive attributes and positive reinforcing positive things in the child, and then they get to the age where they can get it back. Like, they've accepted it, and it is now them. So they give it back despite what Billy said in class or what Joanne said or what anybody else has to say about how they look. They own it. So it's the same with us, because it's like going back to nothing. It's like going back to the beginning, and then you have to build back up again. So I totally agree with that. And I think that's something that most people don't acknowledge or are aware of until they get to that destination. So I think it's great that you put it out there for people to more consciously aware of it as they're going through it, because then we have more power and we have more control, and we can learn more and gain more when we are aware of what's happening. Versus getting to the destination and saying, oh, that's where I was going on this journey, or that's what we're after.
Right. And that's pretty much what Curly Crown is about. And, you know, you can check out the website, curlycrown.com, and it'll send you the link to where it is on Amazon. It is free until Saturday, the volume one of the 90-day natural hair transitioning program. And you're exactly right. Getting to that point of liberation, of embracing your crown and glory, and that's what Curly Crown is about. And I thank you so much for this opportunity to come on the show and talk about my book.
You're welcome. Now, are you on Facebook or Twitter? Do you want to let people know how they can get in contact with you there as well?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, plug yourself.
Yes, ma'am. I do have a Curly Crown Facebook fan page, and you can reach me at Mel Hoston on Facebook. The Twitter ID is Melia, M-E-L-I-A-V, at A-T-C-C. So it's Melia V at Curly Crown, and it's just the acronym, the CC is the acronym for Curly Crown. And, you know, it's just, you know, we're at the humble beginning, so it's just getting there, getting the momentum and establishing a good base in order to, you know, successfully grow and keep it growing for the long term.
All righty. Well, we would like you to definitely keep us updated and revisit in regards to your, you know, the upcoming projects that you mentioned, and just any time, come back and we're definitely interested in knowing more and more as everything, you know, unfolds. So a lot of people are tapping into these things that's just been sitting inside them or growing inside them. And that's why somebody can say to you, like, man, that was fast. It's because it's been there. I know Robin, me, all us women, it's like where the light bulb is going off. Man, you know, we have so many ideas, plans, and projects within us, and now's the time to let them out. Ready or not, let them out. So, I thank you
exactly.
so much for
exactly.
coming by, and keep us posted, and come back very soon.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
All right. Have a wonderful evening.
Good evening. All right. Bye-bye.
I present to you the 90-day natural hair transitioning program. Change can be difficult, and it can be scary, but with the proper organization and preparation that I offer to you in this daily program that only takes minutes a day, I can help you transition from a chemical state to a non-chemical state easy, effortlessly, and feeling very good and self-worth. And then for this very special time, for my birthday on September 3rd, I am offering volume one of the 90-day natural hair transitioning program for free for 5 days. And then if you sign up for the email link below, when volume two comes out, it also will be free for 5 days in the month of September as my gift to you for my birthday to help me celebrate my birthday and fulfilling my goals and my dreams to help women empower themselves and feel self-worth through their hair, through their crown and glory. So please fill out the email, share, and like me on Facebook at my Facebook page. I thank you so much. Again, my name is Malia B, and I'm with Curly Crown.
Because you never know what life is going to take you, and you can't change where you've been. But today, I have the opportunity to choose. Here I am now, looking at 30, and I got so much to say. Gotta get this off of my chest, I gotta let it go today. I was always too concerned about what everybody would say. But I can't live for everybody, I gotta live my life for me, yeah. I preach the fork in the road of my life, and nothing gonna happen unless I decide to be the best that I can be.
I choose
to be authentic in everything.
been through some painful things. I thought that I would never make it through. Filled up with shame from the top of my head to the soles of my shoes. I put myself in